In the early years, many had attempted to venture the vast land of the Amazon jungle. There were stories from explorers in the 18th century that discussed their findings in the dangerous territory. While some survived and lived on to tell and write about their journey, there were some who disappeared into the unknown. One of them was a famous explorer named Percy Harrison Fawcett. Born on August 18, 1867, Fawcett grew up at a small seaside town in Devon, England. In his teenage years, he moved to southeast London to attend the Royal Military Academy in Woolwich. As he gained much experience there, he became a captain at the age of 30 and was dispatched to multiple locations in Asia. But after serving for more than 5 years, he grew tired of the military life and decided to follow his passion for land exploration. In 1901, he joined the Royal Geographical Society, where he studied surveying and map making. After 5 years, in 1906, he was ordered to travel to South America to map out the jungle area around the Bolivia and Brazil border. When he and his crew arrived at their destination, they came across the indigenous tribe living in the area, and just as expected, the tribes weren't very friendly to them because they thought they were there to steal their resources or capture them to be sold off for slavery. But with Fawcett's respectful approach to the tribe, the two parties eventually established a good relationship. His time spent with the tribe made him realize the difficult life in the Amazon jungle, and at the same time, he was fascinated on how they were able to survive in the unforgiving environment. With the help from tribe members, Fawcett's task to map out the area had gotten easier. He had easy access to various locations where he would normally struggle to enter, and the tribe gave him warning when approaching a dangerous area. On one occasion, while he was walking around the jungle, he stumbled upon a strange discovery. He found weird pottery fragments and paintings that had very distinct design. When he closely examined the artifacts, it contained mysterious markings that he believed came from the early civilization. Fawcett had a keen interest in ancient mysteries. He had read various stories about how the people back then supposedly had superior technology and advanced medicine. There was one specific manuscript that caught his attention. The letter was written by a Portuguese hunter from 1753, which the explorer claimed that during his trip to South America, he found clues which suggested that an ancient city lies hidden in the Amazon rainforest. Convinced by this, Fawcett believed that there was a great possibility that a secret city is somewhere deep in the jungle. He referred to this city as Z. In 1914, even after he finished his task on mapping the assigned area, he stayed for a couple more days in hope to find the lost city. However, this was cut short because it was during the time that World War I broke out, and Fawcett was forced to go back to Britain to serve in the army. In 1920, after recovering from minor injuries, he returned to South America to find the lost city. He received a hint that the city may lie in the middle of Mato Grosso, the western part of Brazil that borders with Bolivia, an area he was quite familiar with. Even though he mapped the majority of the zone, his attempt to find the city was proven to be a struggle. He had no clue where to start, and what's even worse, they encountered dangerous animals and had many close calls. Combine this with severe weather conditions, Fawcett and his crew didn't last long and decided to forfeit the mission and return to Britain. Even after a huge setback, Fawcett was determined to find the lost city and wanted to try again. But this time, the problem he faced was the financial support for the second expedition. Many had warned him about the dangers of the journey and even called him crazy to even attempt to find a mythical city. Despite the public's doubt, Fawcett managed to raise enough funds to go for a second round. This time, he brought along his 22-year-old son, Jack, and his friend, Raleigh. They first landed to Rio de Janeiro to properly prepare for the long journey ahead of them. They brought along 2 horses, 2 dogs, 8 mules, and hired 2 Brazilian laborers to help them carry the extra weight. Before Fawcett and his crew ventured into the deep, uncharted territory, he wrote a letter to his wife, and at the end of the letter he wrote, "I expect to be in touch with the old civilization within a month. You need not have any fear of failure." This was the last communication they had. There are several theories on their disappearance, The most obvious one was that they were killed by a vicious tribe or died from an illness. But there is a theory which claimed that Fawcett planned this all along. He wanted to leave his old life and disappear to live among the tribe. As of today, there is still no concrete evidence on what happened to them.